Good morning, DCHS. We're glad to have your attention for a few minutes this morning to explain some important information. First off, let us formally introduce ourselves as your high school guidance counselors. I'm Mr. Emmett, as most of you know from Dade Middle School, and I'll be working closely with freshmen and sophomores.
And I'm Ms. Davenport, and while I'll be focusing on the juniors and seniors primarily, Mr. Emmett and I work closely together, so if you need to see either of us at any time, we're here to serve all students, so come see us. There are only two of us, so this form that you're seeing right now on screen helps us prioritize need based on what each student needs, whether it's academic, personal, social, or if it's a crisis situation, we prioritize. So we will get to each of you as soon as we can if you fill these out with Ms. Meeks in the front office.
Yeah, and Ms. Meeks has these in the front office. Make sure to fully complete the form before you give it back to her. She will make sure that we get these. We plan to conduct several video lessons this school year and hope that they're very informative to you. This first video lesson will hopefully open your eyes to the importance of high school graduation.
Also, we hope to get you thinking about how the classes that you're taking right now in high school are going to link you directly to your chosen work or career after graduation. And finally, we want you to understand the importance of scheduling your academic elective classes based on your future goals.
I propose one question to you students. Why are you here? To graduate. Wouldn't you agree, Ms. Davenport?
Of course. But I have one question. After graduation, what comes next?
Here's what some of your classmates have to say about what their plans are for life after high school graduation.
I'm going to University of West Georgia to become a speech pathologist.
I'm going to go to college for engineering.
I want to go to college and be a surgeon.
Go to college and be a veterinarian.
I want to go to college and be a guidance counselor.
To go to college and be a pediatrician.
Going to college, four-year university for engineering.
I've got two options. I want to get my education and be a teacher or be a missionary.
I want to be an actress.
Now that you've seen their plans, let's ask them what they're doing right now to help them accomplish these plans.
I'm taking anatomy to get some of the medical courses out of the way.
And I'm working in SolidWorks to further my engineering knowledge.
I'm in Ms. Savini's class.
Math and science.
Senior year, I'm going to take psychology. Right now, I'm taking English.
I'm in Ms. Savini's health class, and we're learning terms.
Doing wrong with math to exempt my freshman year.
I am learning social skills and how to interact with all kinds of people.
I've taken theater all 4 years.
These students can't accomplish their goals by themselves, and neither can you.
Our mission as a school is to provide you the opportunity to become an independent, hardworking, lifelong learner.
Your closest allies are your teachers. They want you to succeed no matter what life plans are. That can include technical college, a four-year school, a training program, or even straight to work after high school.
Oh, hey there. I'm Coach Hurst, the broadcasting teacher. I would like for you to be able to develop a good sense of humor when you take my class. Also, timeliness is next to godliness.
Personal characteristics. One of the most important things that I can think of that I could teach anybody would have a good, how to have a good work ethic and the results that you can obtain from that, because that's what they'll, when they leave us, that's what they'll encounter most out there in the working world is how can I get there on time? Can I use the best use of my time? And how I can benefit myself through an employer? So a good work ethic is important.
It's important for our students to have academic integrity, to be trustworthy, and above all, leadership skills.
Ownership. Work-study skills and ethics.
Good personal characteristics for students to develop would be work ethic and responsibility, just showing up when you're supposed to, turning things in when you're supposed to. That'll help them more in life than anything else.
A personal characteristic that our students need to learn is taking responsibility for their actions and their grade, because in the future, they're not going to have anyone to hold them accountable for that except for themselves.
Right. And they also need to learn self-discipline, which goes along with that, because if they are disciplined to do their work, then they will get it done and they will end up with good grades and they will have self-motivation to succeed.
Well, we want them to learn science, obviously, but there are some skills they need in all classes and throughout their life. One is time management skills. They need to be able to work effectively, efficiently, get their work done on time. That will go a long way to a good career in the future.
I think by far the most important characteristic for our students here at Dade High School to learn or develop are hard work skills, because no matter what field or industry or education they decide to go into, hard work is by far the most important characteristic they need to learn, because it's going to help them to be successful with whatever career they decide to pursue.
Here's what your teachers have to say about preparing you for a future career.
So some skills that you will learn for your future, hopefully how to speak correctly, you know, how to enunciate your words, and how to speak in front of people and not be nervous, because that's always fun to do. What else? I don't know. Let me think for a second.
The one thing that I want them to, there's three things actually, but the first thing would be how to work with other people. If you can work with others, you know, group assignments and just group work and things like that, if you can do that, you've come a long way. Also how to manage yourself. You know, you can do a lot on your own without having to have supervision, and that comes with time. It's kind of acquired, but a little practice always works. And how to achieve results. The one thing that always did that I felt good about, the feeling of how to achieve results, how to be successful. When you feel that for the first time, you want to do it again. So achieving results is the third thing that I would hope my students learn.
I think it's important for students to have leadership skills. It will help them in both their personal and professional lives.
How to grow an amazing beard.
Ownership. Study skills. To endeavor to persevere. And metacognition. You need to know what you know. It's a resource.
We talk a lot about opportunity cost, about every choice you make, you're giving up something. So they're going to use that throughout their life. I tell them every day the world needs grown-ups.
Skills that our students need for the future is working together and in groups, because
collaboration.
Mm-hmm. Because in the workplace, sometimes you get paired with people that you don't want to be paired with, but you all have a common task, and
not
so you
like
have to
us,
get it
though,
done.
No, we work well together.
Okay.
And it's an English class, so they also, obviously, the writing, the reading skills, even just filling out a college application or a job application, they need to be able to write coherent sentences. We do a lot of writing in literature in high school, and that will help them whatever they do.
Hopefully critical thinking. It's not just memorizing and spitting it back out. Hopefully they are thinking the problems through, understanding, and that can go a long way in the future too.
I think the most important skill that they're they're using on a day-to-day basis is problem-solving skills, because no matter what content, language, math, science, social studies, if they can learn to solve complex problems, one day they're going to be able to solve the problems within their career, within their educational careers, and then even our world problems if they have good problem-solving skills.
Now that you've heard from some of the teachers in the building, how about your new graduation coach?
Hi, my name is Sandy Bradley. I'm the new graduation coach here at Dade County High School. I took Mr. Boward's role in graduation coach, and I'm very excited to be here. I've enjoyed getting to know many of you already this year. My job primarily is to make sure that you graduate on time and that you have the credits you need. Some of you know me through credit recovery, which is where students are recovering their missed credits. Maybe you had a bad freshman year and you're having to retake things. There's a lot of different reasons why people are in credit recovery, but you will see me working a lot with that. In regards to the skills that you all need, some of the skills that I see and the characteristics I see used through the credit recovery process are going to help you as you leave high school. Perseverance, staying with it, sticking through it, on the days that you don't want to be here, when you get tired of it, just being able to stick with it, and perseverance is a really important trait. And also being able to have that strong work ethic is crucial as you go out into the work world, into the technical world, school world, wherever you go when you leave here. It's really important that you have a strong work ethic and are willing to do your part to ensure the success of yourself. And only you can do that. So it's very important. And if you ever feel that you're having a hard time with your classes or you're struggling, you're worried about your credits, feel free to come see me and I will do my very best to help you.
So now you know how important a high school diploma is. So in our Bringing It Local segment of this video, we're going to focus on the Vanguard plant that's coming to Trenton.
A new assembly plant will be built in Dade County. Vanguard National Trailer Corporation makes semi-trailers for big rigs. Work begins this week on the $30 million project at the County Industrial Park. The factory will crank out 10,000 semi-trailers a year and employ 400 people. Hiring starts next spring and business should begin by July 2016.
The jobs we found posted online for another Vanguard plant in the United States listed a high school diploma as a requirement for employment. Now for graduation requirements. Do you know what a credit is?
Simply stated, you earn one credit for each class you pass. For example, you have the opportunity to earn 8 credits for this school year because you're enrolled in 8 courses.
According to this chart, a certain number of credits, or units, have to be earned in certain subject areas. For example, class of 2016, the seniors this year need 24 units to graduate. Four units or credits in English, math, and science, 3 in social studies, and so on. Notice the units actually increase for the juniors, then the sophomores, then the freshmen. This next chart shows the typical academic course progression during your high school career. You have your normal class progression listed there for English, English 1, 2, 3, and 4, the math, science, and social studies progression. Also on your screen is an honors or AP class progression. We also offer CTAE courses here at Dade County High School. In case you don't know, CTAE stands for Career, Technical, and Agricultural Education. These are the classes you get to choose based on your interest and possible future career. Courses and class progression are shown. Notice we will offer a new CTAE pathway beginning next school year, AgriScience, which has a pathway of agricultural science, animal science, and then plant science.
Be thinking about the classes you need or want, so scheduling for next year will go smoothly. Please come to us if you have any concerns or questions about your credits earned. Thanks for listening to us today, y'all. Your cohort teacher will give you a summary activity to complete, so please answer the 3 questions honestly and leave it with your teacher. They will make sure it gets back to us.
Please feel free to come talk with us about any issue or concern, question you may have. As we leave you this morning, you need to remember 2 words for tomorrow. Roll Tide.
Excuse me. Go Dogs.
We can agree to disagree on this issue. Have a good day and see you again soon.
For real. They're close.
Oh, shut up. Cry me a handful, you baby.